Hello dear students and very warm good morning to all of you. So we are discussing our lesson that is nothing but what? Nutrition in animals. And in that we are discussing the our first point that is very major point that is nothing but what? Digestion in human. Okay. So in the digestion of the human there are different digestive organs that we have already discussed. Among that digestive organ we have discussed about the buccal cavity or the mouth cavity. Okay, so today we will move for the next digestive organ that is nothing but what? Pharynx and esophagus. Okay, pharynx and esophagus. Okay, so before that going to see the esophagus, we will discuss the very small but which is very important digestive organ, we can say that is nothing but what? Pharynx. Okay, so see here we can see the model of the digestive system. So up till now we have discussed about the mouth cavity or the buccal cavity. Okay, so this mouth cavity or the buccal cavity leads into the pharynx. Okay, leads into the pharynx, or also we can say that the alimentary canal or the respiratory tract or the digestive tract shares the same track. Okay, share the same passage, and that passage is called as what? Pharynx. Okay, so the digestive tract and the respiratory tract share one common passage, and that common passage, that muscular common tube of the passage is called as what? Pharynx. Okay, so the pharynx is nothing but what? One muscular tube. In that what happened? It shares by the digestive tract and the respiratory tract. In this what we can say that pharynx can transport the air also and water also, or the food also we can say that. So the pharynx can share the air which is coming from the respiratory tract, and then it can also passes the food and the water which is coming from the digestive tract. Okay, so in this way the pharynx helps the the pharynx can connect the esophagus, okay, with stomach. Okay, so this pharynx has the three parts. Okay, we'll discuss about that three parts: the upper part, middle and the lower. Okay, so the upper part of the pharynx allows only air. Okay, is from the upper part of the pharynx only the air is coming up inside. Next one is that pharynx, the middle part of the pharynx allows food and air, means both the things can get passed through that passage, and the lower part of the pharynx allows only food. Okay, so in this way these are the three parts of the pharynx, and according to the three parts there are the different types of the thing get passes through that. From the upper part air pass, from the middle part food and air both can get passed, and from the lower part only the food is getting passed. Okay, so here we can say that the digestive tract and the respiratory tract shares the same passage which is called as what? Pharynx. Okay, do you think any time that how it get passage, or how the food and the air both can get passed through it? Why they cannot get mixed, or how the air and water or the food cannot get mixed? Because that we can say that, so at the end of the pharynx we can say that there is one muscular flap. Okay, and that muscular flap is called as what? Epiglottis. Okay, that muscular flap is called as epiglottis. So with the help of the epiglottis, whenever we are swallowing the food, that time the respiratory tract get closed, and whenever we are taking air inside, that time the digestive tract get closed. Okay, so with the help of the epiglottis, our body can avoid the mixing of the water and the food. Okay so in this way what we can say that with the epiglottis what happen? Whenever we are taking air, the air can get passed through the windpipe, and that time this epiglottis can close the food pipe. Okay, this is we can say that food pipe, and this is the respiratory, or we can say that windpipe. Okay, so whenever the air is coming from the windpipe, it can goes to the respiratory tract very easily, and that time the food pipe get closed by the epiglottis, and whenever the food is coming into the digestive tract. That time the windpipe get closed by the epiglottis. Okay, so in this way the food and the air cannot get mixed with the help of this epiglottis, and that is the reason we cannot swallow the food and we cannot inhale the air at the same time. Okay, the food and the air we cannot swallow at the same time because of this reason. Okay, so one is getting closed, then only the second one will get open with the help of their flap like structure, that is nothing but what? Epiglottis. Okay, and that is the reason sometimes we are feeling the choke up or we are feeling cough, we are suffering from the cough whenever we are having the food very hurriedly or whenever we are laughing or talking while having the food. So that time what happens? Instead of going the food particles into the food pipe, by mistakenly it goes into the windpipe. Okay, so if you are having the food very hurriedly, laughing or talking while having the food, then by mistakenly instead of the going the food into the food pipe, it goes into the windpipe and we are having cough or we get choke up. Okay, because of this reason. Okay, so this is about all pharynx. Okay, now we'll move for the next digestive organ, that is nothing but what? Esophagus. Okay, so the pharynx get ends into the esophagus. Okay, so from the pharynx the semi partially digested food or the partially small pieces of the food comes into the esophagus. Okay, now let's discuss about the esophagus. So esophagus is known as food pipe. So that esophagus is also called as what? Food pipe. Okay, it is about 25 centimeter long. Next one, it connects the pharynx to the stomach. Okay, so here you can say that this passage we can say that pharynx and this is esophagus. Okay, so what is the use of this esophagus? This pharynx or this buccal cavity get connected to the stomach with the help of this esophagus. Okay, so this pharynx get connected to the stomach with the help of the esophagus. Also we can say that the buccal cavity or the mouth cavity can get connect to the stomach with the help of this esophagus. Okay, next one, muscular contraction are called peristalsis. Okay, so in this way, see, from the buccal cavity the food reaches to the esophagus. Okay, the food get reaches to the esophagus. Okay, but how it get reaches to the esophagus? From this buccal cavity the food get comes into the esophagus with the help of the continuous contraction and relaxation of the muscles. Okay, continuous contraction and the relaxation of the muscles, and that process is called as what? Peristalsis. Okay, continuous for the muscles of these esophagus can get contract and relax, and because of that the food gets slowly pushed downside. Okay, and that method is called as what? That process is called as what? Peristalsis. Muscular contraction are called peristalsis. And also we can say that what? It's a wave like motion. Okay, so this peristalsis is nothing but the wave like motion, and because of that wave like motion the food can get easily passed down or can get pushed downside. Okay, we can say that not only in the esophagus this peristalsis is happen, but throughout the digestion process from the buccal cavity up till the anus the food get pushed down with the help of this peristalsis motion only, or the peristalsis process only. Means throughout the alimentary canal the food is passing from the different digestive organs, and that passing of the food from the different digestive organ is happens with the help of this peristalsis movement. Okay, or the with the help of this peristalsis motion, that is nothing but we can say that what? A wave like motion. Okay, so this is about what? Pharynx and esophagus. Okay, pharynx and the esophagus. So with the help of the pharynx the food get passed into the esophagus, and from the esophagus the food comes into the next digestive organ, that is nothing but what? Stomach. Okay, so from the esophagus the partially digested food comes into the stomach. Okay, so now we will discuss about the stomach. So let's discuss about the next digestive organ, that is nothing but what? Stomach. So from the esophagus, the partially digested food. Okay, see, listen student, it is very important that digestion not started or digestion never get finished into the esophagus. Okay, only the esophagus helps to transport the food from the buccal cavity to the stomach. Okay, so the partially digested food or the partially bitten food comes into the stomach. And what happens in the stomach? Now we will see. See here. So within this alimentary canal, or among all the digestive organ, the stomach is the most widest part of the alimentary canal. Okay, so the stomach is the widest part of alimentary canal, and it is the muscular J shaped. Okay, if we'll talk about the English letter J, then the shape of the stomach is the like a J letter, and it is like a bag. Okay, so stomach is a muscular J-shaped bag-like structure. Also, it is the widest part of alimentary canal. Okay, next one, the inner wall of the stomach contains the different gastric glands. Okay, the inner wall of the stomach contains the different types of the gastric glands which secreted the different digestive juices or the different gastric juices. Okay, so this inner wall of the stomach contain different gastric glands, and they are secreted certain types of the gastric juices, or also we can say that what, digestive juices. Okay, so which digestive juices secreted by the inner wall of the stomach? They secrete the gastric or the digestive juices which contain three substances. Okay, so the gastric glands which are present in the stomach secreted the different digestive juices or the gastric juices, and the gastric juices contain the different substances like hydrochloric acid, pepsin and mucus. Okay, they contain the hydrochloric acid, pepsin and mucus. Okay, so now all about these all substances we will see deeply. In the stomach, the different gastric juices are getting produced, and that different gastric juices are having the different substances like what, hydrochloric acid, mucus and pepsin. Okay, so let's discuss about that. So why there is a hydrochloric acid present in the stomach? Because whenever we are having the food, so with the help of that food, certain types of the germs or the bacteria also get enters into our stomach. Okay, so our stomach contains this hydrochloric acid. Because of that hydrochloric acid, the medium of our stomach becomes acidic. Okay, so in that acidic medium, whenever the germs or the bacteria enters, they cannot survive and they can get killed. Okay, so with the help of this hydrochloric acid, the harmful bacteria can get killed which are coming with the help of the food. Okay, so this is about hydrochloric acid. Now we'll discuss about the next one, that is what, mucus. Okay, so the mucus protects the inner lining of the stomach from the action of enzyme. Okay, so what is mean by enzyme? In our previous video already we have discussed enzyme means what. These are the certain chemical substances which helps to increase the speed of the chemical change. Okay, or we can say that these are the bio catalyst. Now biocatalyst means what, or catalyst means what? The catalyst, these are the substances which cannot take the part in the chemical reaction, but they increase the rate of the reaction. They helps to keep that process very fast. Okay, so in this way we can say that what, enzymes, these are the biocatalysts. Enzymes means what? They are not taking the part in any chemical change, but they helps to boost that chemical change, or they helps to do that chemical change very fastly. Okay, so in this way these are about the enzymes and mucus. So the mucus helps to keep the inner lining of the stomach from the action of enzymes. Okay, so because of that mucus, what happened, the inner lining of the stomach can get protected with the help of enzymes action, different enzymes action. Because of the mucus, the inner lining of the stomach can get protected with the help of the, or from the actions of different enzymes. Next one we will discuss that, or the next substance which are present in the gastric juices, that is nothing but what, pepsin.
So what is the role of this pepsin? This pepsin can convert the large protein molecules into smaller protein molecules. Okay, so this pepsin can convert the large protein molecules into the small protein molecules, and that small protein molecules is called as nothing but what? Peptones. Okay, or we can say that the pepsin can convert the complex protein into the simple soluble form of the protein, and a simple soluble form of the protein is called as what? Peptones. Okay, so in this way, this is the role of the pepsin, or these are the certain enzymes which converts the complex proteins into the simple proteins, and that simple protein is called as what? Peptones. Okay, so in this way, these are the different enzymes which are present in the stomach. This is what? Pepsin. There is a mucus, and this is what? Hydrochloric acid. Among that, pepsin is only the enzymes, we can say that. And the mucus can protect the inner lining of the stomach from the action of enzymes. The hydrochloric acid can help to kill the bacteria which can comes with the help of the food. Okay, so this is about what? Stomach. So the one end of the stomach, here you can see that the one end of the stomach get connected to the esophagus, and the lower end of the stomach can get connected to the small intestine. Okay, so from the esophagus, when the food is coming into the stomach, that time the stomach wall or the mouth of the stomach can get opens. Once the food can get enters into the stomach, the mouth of the food can get closed. Okay, so once the food can come inside, it cannot comes outside from the stomach. Okay, next one we will see that. So in the stomach, what happens in the stomach? The churning of the food is happens, means the food get mechanically churned into the stomach, or the churning of the food is happens into the stomach, and at the end that food can get converted into partially digested semi-solid food, which is called as what? Chyme. Okay, so at the end in the stomach, what happened? Because of the churning, the food can get converted into partially digested semi-solid food, and that partially digested semi-solid food is called as what? Chyme. Okay, in this way, that chyme can get now pass to the next digestive organ, that is nothing but what? Small intestine. For the small intestine, about the small intestine, we will discuss in the next video. Okay, so this is all about stomach. From the stomach, the partially digested semi-solid food, or we can say the paste of the semi-solid food, can get transferred to the small intestine, and that paste of the food is called as what? Chyme. Okay, so this is all about the stomach. We will meet in the next video, and that time we will discuss about the next digestive organ. For today, thank you.